never caught a ling caught this big in my life.
We've all heard the saying, it doesn't take much to make a man happy. And in this case, that statement couldn't be more accurate. As long as the boys are whacking big fish, the stoke is running high. In the last couple of weeks, we've whacked a couple of big fish. But there's only one problem. When you think of spearfishing, you usually imagine something along the lines of this, or this, but certainly not this. But on the Oregon coast, that's what our ocean looks like 97% of the time. And not to mention, it's really cold. So if you're in the business of whacking fish, you gotta put your big boy pants on and go make it happen. But there's a small little secret I'll let you in on. Every now and then when the boys are feeling extra ambitious, we make a small 7-hour drive to a small tribal town in the very northwestern part of the contiguous US called Nia Bay. If there's one thing you need to know about Nia Bay, it's that the fish are bigger and the visibility is a lot better. So without further ado,
going out spearfishing today.
Now we're talking, bro. This is the kind of energy I need at a depot at all times.
Bubbles. Bubbles.
Your stuff's in there. Loop, quarters, everything.
Damn. I'm running stacks deep.
Bro, stack.
This is where the boys suit up and unsuit up. This is where the magic happens. Unreal. As soon as we slipped into our wetsuits, the excitement doubled instantly and we were off to our first spot of the day, which is an area we've been looking at and wanting to hit for quite some time now. Upon arrival, the locals made it very clear to us that they are not interested in us being here. They did something we've never seen before. They got into a gang, they circled our boat, they took turns charging and splashing at us and making it very evident that they do not want us diving here. The wind and swell was very rough out there anyway, so we went inside to a more protected area and decided to try our luck here.
Derek with the first catch of the day, scallop.
So the boys are saying the water is freezing, 46 degrees, and if that's true, then that's not good news. Because last time it was 49 here, and I was freezing. Especially when we're out on the boat for a couple days diving, you get cold fast. So I'm stoked to get in. They said viz is like 30 plus feet, which is, it doesn't get better than that out here. See you guys in the water.
Every time you enter the water this far up north, you're met with two very strong wows. Wow number one is, wow, this water is freezing. Wow number two is, wow, this visibility is insane. So there's a lot of wows to get past in the first couple seconds. But after that, you slowly start getting used to the temperature change and starting from your face to your hands to your feet and slowly through your body, everything goes numb and you can finally start focusing at the mission ahead. And luckily, the mission is very easy. Put fish in the cooler. And this first spot wasn't as productive. We weren't seeing too much, but we were seeing scallop. So that's Damien shooting his pole spear into a scallop, prying it off the wall. This might be a first of its kind if I've ever heard of it. I am a little more delicate with my gear. So after I see this scallop, instead of trying to shoot it off, I try to pry it off or punch it off with my pole spear, but with no luck, I go back to the surface.
That's probably my favorite scallop.
That's the prettiest scallop too. Well, all we got from that dive was three scallops. And then remember that shellfish have toxic levels in Washington right now. So hey, you should release your baby.
Such a nice one.
Yeah, that is a very nice scallop.
Later.
All right, so all the guys I'm with right now, they're all kind of not the biggest fan of being on video all the time, so it's really funny shooting videos with them because they're all like, as soon as the video comes out, they get all awkward and whatnot. So I'm gonna go around and ask them to help me film the intro video and see how uncomfortably awkward they get. Hey, can you do me a favor though? I'm not feeling the doing the intro video. Can you help me with the intro?
What do you need from that?
Just like, say where we are, what are we doing, how long, the whole thing. Like just intro of the weekend or what we got going on. That's what you can do. I can cut it. I can start whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Ready? All right.
About to hit Nia Bay this weekend. Gonna be out here for 2 days. The most northwest tip of the lower 48 states. Hoping to smack some big ling cod, boys.
That's my boy.
The boys went on to the second spot of the day, and this next dive was certainly my favorite out of the whole trip. I'm not going to talk over this next section. I'm just going to include my favorite clips, and I want you guys to try to enjoy this dive as much as I did.
A 30-inch ling, you can't get back on the boat.
30-inch ling, or we're not friends.
Well, Derek threw out the ling cut on the pavement the other day, and he's sitting there jerking his tail and head in opposite directions, trying to track every vertebrae before he measures him out.
It's crazy what jealousy will
do. Nice medium-sized ling, first drop.
Consider me on my way. Just pulled up to spot number 3. So far, the boys are 0 for 3. No one shot a single fish. No ling cod. The boys are gonna hop in. Hopefully, next time I see you, I'm holding a big ol' ling.
If not, you can hold my big ol' ling.
Yeah, I haven't seen Damien shoot a ling in
30 years.
Yeah, a very long time. So this would be a remarkable day for that.
At this point in the day, the boys knew it was all or nothing on this dive because the current was going to come in hard in the next hour or so. So we knew this is our last chance to put fish in the cooler. I definitely came out a little too hot on this dive, got in the water and immediately started blasting away, missing fish left and right. Totally didn't see that ling cod either. He was a medium size, but it still would have been nice to have him in the boat. But here's the beautiful thing about spearfishing is you could be having the worst day possible, missing all the fish, but all it takes is one fish and one shot to turn it all around. Now there may be some foreshadowing going on here, but at this moment I had no idea that on my next dive at the bottom of the ocean floor was that one fish waiting for me that would turn my day around for the better. So as I approached this pipe, I noticed a big head sticking out of it, and I did not hesitate for 1 second. I let my pole spear fly and it connected directly with his brain, putting him straight out of his misery. He didn't even know what hit him. My boy went straight to sleep. No NyQuil needed. In the spearfish world, that's what we like to call a stone shot. And the best part is, we got matching outfits. So this is what I mean by your day taking a very fast turn. My day went from, well, I was already having a really good day, to be honest with you. Minus the hyperthermia and freezing. I was stoked we were out here. It was beautiful, even though it wasn't so fishy. Like I said, all you need is that one fish to turn it all around. After I dropped him off in the boat, hopped back in the water, the current was already ripping, so you would need to hold on to these kelp as you're breathing up so you're not being drifted away. And we took a couple more dives before it became undiveable with this current and we were back in the boat.
All right, boys, well, I said we can't come back empty-handed, so got a nice ling. I'm happy about this one. I got it on GoPro too, so y'all already know what's up. And then I told y'all, next time y'all see me out of the water, we got ling. So Damien shot 2 ling. Is there a third one in there? Oh, that's a cabazon.
Yeah.
So we got cabazon, 2 ling from Damien, daddy ling, and then 2 nice-sized rockfish. I don't care what you say. These are nice rockfish. This spot provided, the current started ripping hard. So the boys threw out a line and they're holding on as the current's ripping and taking drops. I think me and Damien did our work for today.
Hell yeah.
I'm not really feeling doing the intro for this video. Would you mind introducing and what's going on?
What's up, guys? Thanks for watching. we're up here, the top of the mainland, doing some spearfishing.
freezing our butts off.
Okay, you gotta sound a little more excited. This isn't gonna cut it.
That's why God makes people like me and people like you. This is your job. You do the intro.
18 and a half. Don't forget the half.
Yeah, we'll take it. Big dog's gotta eat.
After Derek, aka Spiro King, just witnessed me putting the biggest ling of the day onto the boat, he insisted that we make one more stop and do one more drift. And we did, but he was the only one in the water. Meanwhile, the boys started cleaning the fish and we had a front row seat to some whales doing their thing, which was cool. After about another hour and no more big ling on the boat, we decided to head back and called it quits. At the end of the day, all the boys are stoked, minus one guy.
Last day today. Back to Devo tomorrow.
Me and David already showered up, cleaned up. The rest of the boys are gonna go do that. Now it's time to clean up all our fish. We're not even gonna make it to the fillet station today.
Straight off the back of the boat.
Oh my God. Your strap that just gave out. Too much fish. With a full backpack and an empty cooler, we could call this day a success with a clear conscience. Even though not everyone got the fish they wanted, we certainly gave it our all. Now we had one more assignment left for the day. Share a meal together and tell stories about all the big fish we almost shot. And most importantly, get ready to do it all over again tomorrow.